Hi, everyone. Sad news, really, if you stop and think about it, coming out of the State House today with the resignation of former Senate President Stan Rosenberg, less than 24 hours after that scathing Senate Ethics Committee report prompted a string of calls from his own allies, Democrats as well as Republicans, calling for him to step down. It's sad because keep in mind, while certainly very few people are stepping up to try to absolve Rosenberg here, we are talking about a human being who has seen the total collapse of both his personal and professional life occur. So anyone that's popping the champagne over this perhaps needs to reevaluate their priorities. But the whole sad saga of Stan Rosenberg raises another question, a broader question, that will survive his resignation. What is wrong within the culture of Beacon Hill, not just in the state Senate, but more generally, where a situation like the one described in that scathing report could occur, where the spouse of a powerful person could allegedly terrorize people up on Beacon Hill and allegedly commit variations of sexual assault and harassment, and everyone's afraid to speak up about it, to say anything about it, even after the story broke. And the investigation began, they set up a hotline, a confidential hotline looking for tips. In the report, they admit they didn't get a single phone call. So there's a broader problem here, a cone of silence, if you will, surrounding the behavior and at times misbehavior of powerful people on Beacon Hill. That's a cultural problem that's going to have to be addressed, even if Stan Rosenberg is no longer around. I'm John Keller. Thanks for watching, and check back often for updates here on CBSBoston.com.